Hello, Internet. We are live, I'm hoping. Anybody here? Oh, Carol Bowes, first person in the room. Hey, Janet. Hey, Carol. Can you guys hear me? Someone say something. You guys there? Oh, there's a comment and a thumbs up. All right, we are live. Welcome back for another solid Friday. Hello, Internet. Hello, Facebook Live. Thank you guys so much for coming and joining me. I am broadcasting from the backyard studio here in beautiful Los Angeles, California. It's almost 100 degrees out there today. You can see the sun is super hot on my window. Hey, Tawana. And welcome back. I am so glad to be here hanging out with you guys on Facebook today. It's been 2 weeks since our last Facebook Live, and I've missed you guys. I look forward to our little chats here. Hey, Eddie, how's everybody doing? Shout out, tell me how you are. Where are you watching from? What are you doing? Is it evening? Is it afternoon like it is for me? Are you guys at work? Are you at home? Hey, Marcy. I'm seeing some familiar, hey Anisha, familiar faces and names coming in. It's great to be here. I've been looking forward to this for a couple weeks. I have some really cool music to play for you today. I've dug up some of my favorites from my catalog. And of course, I'm going to play some music from my new CD, Solid. This is Solid Friday in celebration of the record, Solid. Which, by the way, I just found out is on sale at iTunes today for only $6.99. So if you have not had a chance to pick up the record yet, and you're waiting until it was $6.99 at iTunes, today is the day to go over and to iTunes, and you can get a discount version of the record to listen to on your device. Hey, Susan. Susan is working, trying to work, right? Well, I guess I am working. I do want to say thank you to the Smooth Jazz Cruise for sponsoring another edition of Solid Friday. I'm very grateful to the Smooth Jazz Cruise for that and also just for existing because I love the Smooth Jazz Cruise. I'm not sure how many of you guys I have seen out there on the ship over the years. I've been doing this for over 10 years. And co-hosting for just a few, I co-host the cruises with Marcus Miller, the incredible bass player and producer and recording artist and film scorer and everything. You know, Marcus is really just a legend and deservedly so. And I am honored to co-host the cruise with Marcus. We usually do two a year. Of course, they've all been canceled this year and one was postponed to next year, and then all three of those cruises were canceled and postponed to 2022. So I've got three cruises with the Smooth Jazz Cruise scheduled for 2022, January through whenever. So we're going to have 3 weeks at sea, and I really hope to see some of you guys there. If you haven't been, it really is the most incredible musical experience and just a great vacation, too, because you're on this beautiful ship. And it's me and Marcus and Brian Culbertson's going to be there, Candy Dulfer, Jonathan Butler, Rick Braun, Richard Elliott, you know, just a who's who of contemporary instrumental music. And we're all just hanging out on the ship together out in beautiful ocean, and it's just incredible. So I urge you guys to check that out for 2022. Greetings, David Sims. If you guys have anything you wanted to chat about before I play some music, just let me know. I did want to say I'm really excited. I've got my main axe back today. I hadn't mentioned it, but the last, I don't know, 7 or 8 of these Facebook Lives I've been doing, I was playing my backup saxophone because this horn wasn't working so great. And because of the pandemic, I hadn't taken it into the shop. You know, the shop was closed for a while, and then when he opened it up, I didn't really want to go hang out over there anyway. So I finally brought the horn in to have it repaired last week, so I've got my main axe back now, and it's really a joy to play. You sax players, if you're ever in Los Angeles and you need saxophone repairs, go see Manny at the Horn Connection because he does a great job. My friend Jeff wanted me to tell you guys, I was telling him how happy I was to have the horn back, and he said, tell him about that time when you broke your horn on the road. I think some of you guys might have even been there. This is a question I had for you. Have you all seen me play live, or all you guys like people that come to my shows, or are some of you guys that just have discovered me on Facebook? That was something I was curious about. Anyway, I was on the road a few years ago in Buffalo, New York, and at the end of the show, I say, thank you very much, you know, good night, and I hold the horn over my head, and I turned to walk off the stage, and I tripped on the edge of the keyboard riser, and with full force momentum, I just planted myself flat on the ground, face first, fell really hard with my horn held in my hand over my head, and just crashed it into the ground, and just really messed it up. I mean, it wouldn't, not a note would come out of the horn. And we had a show the next night in New Jersey, so I was a little bit freaked out, to say the least. And we went back to the hotel, and I thought, all right, I'll call David Sanborn, who I had met on the Smooth Jazz Cruise and become friends with. And we called him late at night and left a message. He called me back just a few minutes later, and he was in Europe, so it was morning for him. And he's a New Yorker. So I said, what should I do? Who should I call in New York? And he said, you have to find this guy, Bill Singer. He said, I'll call him and tell him to make space for you to come in tomorrow. So David Sanborn actually called his repairman and arranged for us to go to his repair shop in Manhattan. We dropped the band off at the gig in New Jersey, and then my tour manager and I went to Manhattan, and Bill Singer, over the next 5 or 6 hours, did surgery on my horn and was able to fix it in time for the show. So I'm very grateful to Bill Singer and to David Sanborn for that particular experience. You get, the horn has to be working to play well. Jennifer, listening for many years but hasn't seen a show yet. That's awesome. Joyce says she's seen me live several times. Was supposed to see me tonight in Columbus, Ohio. See you next October. Yeah, wow. I mean, we had a whole bunch of shows scheduled for this year for the Solid Tour, and all of them have been pushed to next year. If you guys had tickets for any of those shows, they'll all be good for next year, and just keep an eye on the tour page, and fingers crossed we're going to be back to work by then. Pellegrino says hello. All right, I'm going to get into playing some music because I have some cool stuff I want to play today. Four times, wow. So the first song I want to play is, this is a tune that I used to start the show with, and then we've sort of retired it a long time ago and haven't played it for quite a while. But I'm excited to play this song because it features the great George Benson on guitar. This is a tune on the Shine CD. And I had written this song. I wrote this tune by myself, and it just reminded me a little bit of a sort of 1970s contemporary jazz sounding track. And I thought, boy, it would be great to get Benson on there. So we were able to hook it up to go to Arizona, where George Benson lives, and put him on the track. And at that point, I thought, wow, the track just really has that 70s vibe. So in the production, I produced the whole record myself. And for me, production is like a whole other instrument. You know, it's just a great way to express my creativity. So once I got Benson on there, I thought, this sounds so 70s, I wanted to play that up. So for rhythm guitar, I got Wawa Watson to play the rhythm guitar. I don't know if you guys are familiar with Wawa Watson, but he was an incredible session musician that played on. He was in the Funk Brothers with Motown. He played on Papa Was a Rolling Stone. He played on Maxwell Records. Just an incredible rhythm Wawa guitar player. So I got him on there. And then I thought, this really reminds me of those Benson records from the 70s, which had these beautiful Klaus Ogerman string and horn arrangements on them. So I had my good friend Jerry Hay write an orchestral string arrangement to go on top of this. So this is me, George Benson, Wawa Watson, arranged by Jerry and myself, and Tim Carman's playing the acoustic piano on here, Daryl Smith's playing the electric piano, Alex Al on bass, a little John Roberts, incredible drummer. So I was really proud of the way this one turned out production-wise, and I'm going to give it a shot once I make a little adjustment in my situation here. This is a song called Hypnotic. Oh. You guys can see me. This is a song called Hypnotic from the Shine CD, With Any Luck. Mm-hmm. That's called hypnotic, y'all. I forgot to put my hat on. I have to get into character. Otherwise, you don't really know it's me. Hey, Tina, how you guys doing? Sound okay out there? Is it working? Haha, Alta wants to get her hat. I actually just did the video for the Smooth Jazz Cruise recently, and I did it without my hat. And Alonzo Bowden, the comedian for the cruise, said, yeah, I didn't know Boney could play without his hat on. All right, well, I'm going to keep the music coming. I want to play a song off of the new Solid CD. This is another one. This is sort of a deep track off the record. I don't know if it's going to be a single or not, but it's one of my favorite songs, and a number of you guys had mentioned that it was one of your favorite songs as well. I'm going to break it down a little bit for this one. This is a little bit more introspective track on the new CD, and in fact, when we finished recording it, my engineer Dave Rideau said, why is Boney so sad? So I guess I was feeling something when I did this one, and I co-wrote this with Jairus Mosey and Beats Made by Fresh. And it's a really beautiful song. I hope you guys like it. This one's called Last Train Home. Am I having internet problems? Can you guys hear me? Oh well, I'm sorry, y'all. Let's see if there's something happening. It seems like I'm having internet problems. Are we back?
No.
It's frozen? Mm-hmm. All right, well, I'll just keep broadcasting. Sorry, guys.
Like 500 people dropped off.
Okay, well, I'm just going to play my last song, and we'll hope that this is good for the rebroadcast. All right, guys, I'll do one more song. I'm just going to play, Lo.
Okay.
This last tune is called Grand Central, and hopefully you guys are going to hear it. So this is the internet, and I'm going to give it a shot in any event. This is a song called Grand Central, and it's got Questlove playing drums on this one from The Roots. And this is a tune that I recorded at mostly at Electric Ladyland Studios in New York. And this was on the Ride CD, which is kind of a grittier sounding record. We had Russell the Dragon Elevato doing the engineering on this record to try and get a little bit of that sound. So I'm going to play it, and I hope you guys can see me.
Thank you.
Is anybody still there? I guess we had some technical problems. In any event, I'm going to repost this and hopefully it'll work on the repost if you guys want to check in on my Facebook page, and I will post it and hopefully you can watch it at a later time. Sorry about that, guys. It's the internet. And that's all the time we have for today, but I will see you in 2 weeks, and hope all is well. You guys stay safe out there. Thank you so much. Peace.